Here's the conclusion of the matter. Fear God. Keep His commandments. For this is the duty of mankind. For God will bring every deed into judgment, including every hidden thing, whether it be good or evil. Seek the Lord while He may be found. Call upon Him while He's near. Let the wicked forsake their ways, and the unrighteous their thoughts, and let them turn to the Lord, and He will have mercy on them, and to our God, for He will freely pardon. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Show me, Lord, my life, life's end, and the number of my days. Let me know how fleeting my life is. You have made my days a mere handbreadth. The span of my years is as nothing before Thee. Everyone is but a breath, even those who seems secure. Brothers and sisters, we do not want you to be uninformed about those who sleep in death, so that you do not grieve like the rest of creation or mankind who have no hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. And so we believe that God will bring with Jesus those who have fallen asleep in Him. According to the Lord's word, we tell you that we who are still alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will certainly not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord Himself will come down from heaven with a loud command, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump call of God, and the dead in Christ will be raised first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. A very pleasant good morning to you all this morning. Today we are gathered to celebrate the life of Hyacinth May Passley, Yvette, born in February 6th, 1946, and passed away on February 12th, 2024. In the midst of life, we are in death. And so this morning, we're reminded to number our days that we may apply our hearts to knowledge. The opening hymn comes to us, "The Lord's my shepherd, I not want, He makes me down to lie," in the tune of the Happy Wonder. Could we stand as we sing lustily, as we celebrate her life this morning? The Lord's my shepherd, I not want, He makes me down to lie. In pastures green He leadeth me, the quiet waters lie. He for his own name's sake. He lives, he lives, he lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, he lives, he lives, he lives within my heart. Yea, though I walk in death's dark vale, yet will I fear no ill. For thou art with me, and thy rod and staff me comfort still. He lives, he lives, he lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, he lives, he lives, he lives within my heart. My table thou hast furnished in presence of my foes. My head thou dost with oil anoint, and my cup overflows. He lives, he lives, he lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, he lives, he lives, he lives within my heart. Goodness and mercy all my life shall surely follow me, and in God's house forevermore my dwelling place shall be. He lives, he lives, he lives. I know that my Redeemer lives, he lives, he lives, he lives within my heart. Somebody say hallelujah. Bow in prayer. Righteous, loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for the life of Hyacinth. We thank you for the many lives she has touched. We thank you for all our families and friends. We thank you that she is indeed a blessed person. She has drawn many individuals to this location to celebrate her life, and we thank you. We pray this morning that you will so overshadow this service and cause that as we proceed, that the blessings of the Lord will flow and that comfort will be brought to the hearts of the family, and that each one will experience an overwhelming joy that she has lived a good life. Lord, we give you praise. May your anointing be upon this service to your name's honor and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated in God's presence. My name is John Davis, pastor of this local congregation. I will be your moderator this morning, and serving along with me is Minister Robert Bartley, and he will be sharing the word with us this morning. Just a few housekeeping matters. Your restroom will be along that aisle, and you will see a lone building in the middle. At the back, you may use that when you desire to do so. This morning, the first lesson comes to us from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, from verse 6 to 8, and this will be read by Suzanne Allen, followed by a selection from Benito Lazarus. Then we'll have the second scripture, Matthew's Gospel, chapter 11, 28 through to 30, and this will be read by Sona Lewis, that is grandniece. And immediately after the reading of that scripture will be another selection by the Ann's Farm United Club. Please follow your programs and come briskly and serve. You may use the podium on the floor. Thank you very much.
Our first lesson is taken from 2 Corinthians 5, 6 to 8. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that whilst we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willingly, rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. These are the words of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Pleasant good morning, everyone. Well, this tribute is on behalf of the Dasan Limited family for Miss Yvette. Mr. Music Man. Become a friend will do the same for me. So if you ever miss Yvette, let me see you put two hands in the air, whoever you may be. Yeah, I cry for my friend, die for my friend, become a friend will do the same for me. But Miss Yvette, gone, you're gone, you're gone, you're gone. Memories of you lives in your head, even though you're gone, you're gone. You're gone, you're gone. Memories of you lives in your head. Oh, yeah. Gone, you're gone, you're gone. Can't believe it. Gone, you're gone, you're gone, you're gone. Looking back in all the things we did, all the dream never did came through. I wonder why it had to be you. I wonder why it had to be you, yeah. When I lay my head in my bed, she can't believe me, say that he's dead. I know crying won't bring her back. I don't care, I'm gonna cry. Can't believe it. Miss Yvette gone,
I can't believe it.
But not forgotten. Gone, 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 gone. Memories rise in the air, even though you're gone. Miss Yvette gone, but not forgotten.
Hello, good morning, everyone. I'm replacing Siona Lewis. I'm a family friend of Carlene. And the second lesson is taken from Matthew 11, 28 to 30. Even so, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heaven laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Here ends a portion of God's holy word. We honor it by saying, thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Bless the Lord, O my soul. If when you give the best of your service, telling the world that the Savior is come, be not dismayed when men don't believe you. He'll understand and say, well done. Oh, when I come to the end of my journey, he'll understand and say, well done. Misunderstood, the Savior of sinners hung on the cross. He was God's only Son. Oh, hear him call in his and the battle is won, carrying the staff at the cross of redemption. He'll understand and say, well
this life of labor is ended, and the reward, the race you have run, oh, the sweet rest prepared for the faithful will be his blessed and final well done. Oh, when I come to the end of life journey, weary of life and the battle is won, carrying the staff and the cross of redemption, he'll understand and say, well done. If you have tried and fail in your trying, and sore and scars from the work you've begun, take up your cross and run quickly to meet him. He'll understand and say, well done. Oh, when I come to the end of my journey, weary of life and the battle is won, carrying the soul at the cross of redemption, he'll understand and say, well done. Oh, when you come to the end of your journey, weary of life and the battle is won, carrying the staff and the cross of redemption, he'll understand and say, well done. He'll understand and say, well done. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He'll understand and say, well done. The best person to get such commendation from is our Lord. When at the end of one's life, he will understand all the difficulties you have had, but he will say, well done. I want to thank all those who went ahead to have given their tributes, Mr. Lazarus, and the lessons that were read. I pray that you'll continue to experience God's favor on your life. There's a song on the program for Mr. Peter Williams, family friend. Immediately after Mr. Peter has come, there are a few special tributes. Poem from Cadian Williams, that is daughter. Nadija Alexander, granddaughter. Reflection from Mrs. Vanessa Hugg, daughter. There will be a song that is daughters and granddaughters song. A dance from the Westchester Bellone Basic School, and the choir from Ascot Primary will come. You will come in that order. Please follow your programs. Thank you very much. Is Mr. Peter Williams here? Not yet. Okay, could we go to the tributes from Miss Cadian Williams?
Good morning, everyone. All right, so just before I go into this poem, just a bit of backstory. So while I was trying to figure out the type of tribute that I would have given to my mother, I was going through some stuff that I had packed away some time ago. And interestingly, I found some poems that I wrote, like, when I looked at it, it was 23 years ago. And the first one that I actually found was entitled "The Gift of a Mother, a Timely Reminder." And I thought that was no coincidence. And so I decided that I would have to give her this as her tribute. Also, my mother also enjoyed my daughter, this is my daughter, speaking French, right? And so I was saying, I would say the poem and have her translate it in French. And so that is what we're going to do right now. So as I said, the title of the poem is "The Gift of a Mother, a Timely Reminder." There may be times when you may feel down, times of unending sorrow, times when you feel that there hold for you no tomorrow.
Il peut y avoir des moments où vous vous sentez déprimé, des temps de chagrin sans fin, des temps où vous sentez qu'il n'y a pas de lendemain pour vous.
Times of hardship, pain and grief, a hopeless life that seems to have no relief.
Des moments de difficulté, de douleur et de chagrin, une vie sans défense qui ne semble avoir aucun soulagement.
Times seems not to be on your side. Time too short to say it's mine.
Le temps ne semble pas être de votre côté. Le temps trop court pour dire que c'est à moi.
It's times like these that helps you to show all the strength and the determination that you have within to help you grow.
Ce sont des moments comme cela qui vous aident à montrer toute la force et la détermination que vous avez en vous pour vous aider à briller.
It is times like these that we know we are blessed. Times like these that we admire the best.
Ce sont des moments comme cela où nous savons que nous sommes bénis. C'est dans des moments comme cela qu'on vous admire le plus.
You are our mother, strong, precious and loved, a mother truly sent from above.
Vous êtes notre mère forte, précieuse et aimée, une mère véritablement envoyée dans nous.
So when feeling down and hopeless inside, we remember that you are our strength, joy and pride.
Alors, lorsque vous vous sentez déprimé et désespéré intérieurement, rappelez-vous simplement que vous êtes notre force, notre joie et notre fierté.
How do we know that you are all these? How do we know you so well? Let's just say, time did tell.
Comment savons-nous que vous êtes tout cela? Comment pouvons-nous vous connaître si bien? Disons simplement que le temps nous l'a dit.
Thank you.
Merci.
Okay, Miss Nordia, Nordia Alexander is not here. Could we move to the reflection by Mrs. Vanessa Og, daughter? Thank you. So are you saying Miss Alexander just did the poem along? Okay, okay. So could Mrs. Vanessa come?
Good morning, church. This is a tribute to our mom. Oh, mother, mother, you are so dear to us. You were a precious gem sent from God. What more could we ask for? You gave your love unconditionally. There was nothing too hard for you to do when it comes to your children. You sacrificed a lot. You were a virtuous woman, a true example of a mother. Your love, humility, and faith in God never fails. You were always positive about life and always encouraging whenever there's a problem. You always see the good than the bad. You would say your favorite quote, "Pray, leave it to God, time is the master." You were a mother to many, to the young and the old. You were a supporter and also a cheerleader. You were a peacemaker. You had no hate in you. You spread love wherever you go with your beautiful, loving, and caring heart, not to mention your beautiful smile. Thank God for the time He's given you to us. They will be cherished forever. There will never be another mother like you. We will miss having you around, but you'll always be in our hearts. And as you take your final rest, I say, sleep in heavenly peace, Mother. You are now in a better place with your Lord and Savior. Love you, Mommy.
was on her side.
Time was on her side.
Oh yeah. And now that you're gone, I can still feel you near. So I'll try with every tear I cry, though missing you.
I'm assuming, however, that each person has a program, and so the program calls for, if you notice, it is being unannounced, so I'm expecting you to follow your program. So the program calls for a dance from the Westchester Bellone Basic School. Are you here? You're coming? Immediately after the dance, there will be a song from the Ascot Primary Choir. Let me express thanks for the tributes that went ahead. Beautiful tributes. Those who are accustomed to religious circles, you just got a picture of what speaking in tongues and interpreting sounds like. And so thanks for that, the English and the French presentation of that beautiful poem. Could you put your hands together for the Bellone Basic School as they dance.
I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the good.
Morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
My name is Christasia Glenn of Class 4A. I am the Public Relations Officer of the Oscott Primary School Choir and Band. We bring greetings on behalf of our principal, Mr. Mark Jackson, and the Oscott Primary School family. We would like to express our deepest sympathy to the bereaved family. May God peace be with you all. Thank you. Have a blessed day, everyone.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. Very beautiful. Put your hands together one more time for the Ascot Primary Choir. All right. All right. I want to thank all those who have shared their tributes early on. And I pray that continually we will remember what this choir shared with us, to take everything to God in prayer. Amen? I want for us to stand to sing a song at this time. Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Hallelujah. Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Oh, won't it be a time? We're gonna sing and shout, dance about when we get over yonder. We're gonna sing and shout, dance about when we get over yonder. We're gonna sing and shout, dance about when we get over yonder. Oh, won't it be a time? Oh, won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Won't it be a time when we get over yonder? Oh, won't it be a time? Sign me up, oh, for the Christian Jubilee. Write my name upon the roll. I've been changed. Oh, since the Lord have lifted me, I want to be ready when Jesus comes. One more time, sign me up. Oh, for the Christian Jubilee, write my name upon the roll. I've been changed since the Lord has lifted me. I want to be ready when Jesus comes. Put your hands together and celebrate God this morning. Hallelujah. Woo! A day is coming when all our tears will be over. A day is coming when all grief, all loss will be a thing of the past, because God will wipe away the tears from our eyes. Amen? We have three remembrances that is coming up at this time. Remembrances from Miss Patricia Phillips, sister, Mr. Oscott Williams, friend, and Nadeline McNeil, family friend. They will come in that order. Immediately after that, we will have we will be receiving an offering from the congregation. Put your hands together as they come.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's hard to be up here this morning. Yvette. There's so much things I could say about Yvette. But I'm just going to stick to the nearest part I can say. I love her with all my heart. She was my strength. On a Sunday, I live in America. And on a Sunday, when I have a rough week, I would call her. And she would say, "My sister, don't worry, it's going to be okay. Don't let it take away your joy. Just be my sister." And we would talk about stupid little things, but it would help me to face the next week. Because my job is very, very challenging. It's a mental thing, because you work with mental patients. So it's hard. I remember when I was a little girl, she was my big sister, she was my mother, she was my guardian, she was everything. When my brother or my mother would want to bust my behind, she would hide what I did, and she would say, "Don't talk." And when they're gone, she would say, "Listen to me, don't do it again." And I'm not telling you that sometimes she didn't smack me, because she did, because I deserve it. But she was the best person I ever know. I am 63 years old, and I've never met anybody like her. And I don't think I ever will. I miss her, but I'm glad and I'm happy for her. Because you know why? She's no longer in any pain. And she don't deserve to be in pain. And I know selfishly, we wish she was still here. But God was ready for her. And he take her home safely. So all I can ask my family, near and far, ones I talk to and ones I don't talk to, just remember her for the good person that she was. And just embrace that she's going to a better place. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, church. Oh my. As president of this club, Apollo, at this time, Hand Farm were first. My friend, this is a lady who have been one of the hardest, one of the hardest working member in the club. And I tell you that club life is not easy. To lead a club is not easy. To lead a church is not easy. To lead any organization is not an easy road. But you know what happened? Once God is in it, all is well. Once God is in the organization, all is well. We can always call on him to go ahead and lead. I just want to reflect memory on some persons who were a part of the building of this great club. I remember Reverend Colin Cole, who was a minister of this church, probably would say founder. I remember Miss Lewis, our prayer mother, who have passed on. I remember Miss Passley, who have just passed on. Remember Reverend Brown,
Everywhere we go with her, she'll be in our wheelchair and she'll be singing the gospel of the Lord. This is a great, great club. Miss Passley has played a great role in our development of the club. And she wasn't an easy person. I remember the last anniversary we have. We had a barbecue, and you know what happened? I said to these people that the vegetable was getting a go done. And you know what Miss Pastor said to me? Mr. Williams, we are old for vegetable man. What do you? But when the vegetable done and Miss Norma come to me and say, well, money for go buy material for make vegetable. So I turn around and I look at Miss Castley, past Miss Castley. You know what she do? She just take off her hair for me. I'm going to say, yes, sir, it done. I said, Mr. Williams, don't worry yourself. We are getting more and we are looking for more. Don't worry yourself. What I notice of her when she come to our meeting, because everywhere we are, she are there. We have an anniversary. Should I bring out the whole of our children them and grandchildren to our anniversary? Right here at our church. My friend, it's not an easy road because I've lost my mom last year. And every time that I stand here or there, I've always said to people, God will take care. No worry, just easy. But last year when my mother died, it was the hottest thing I ever feel. I feel it. It was hot. But I reflect back that God, thanking God that my mom was a woman who believed in him and to me was serving him. So I kind of back off and take it easy and put it in the hands of the Lord Jesus Christ. And those were the worst day. That day was the worst day when I heard that my mom died. But you know what happened, people? The best thing ever happened to me was when I get saved. You know, you hear the church. When I get saved and baptized, that was the best day of my life. But did you know that right here in this church was when I, first time in my life, I feel the Holy Spirit inside my body? I was sitting somewhere over there, and Reverend Valerie was preaching, and she touched something that inside here, so it moved. Something warm moving me. This is the first time I ever feel it. And you know, I sit down there and don't come to the altar. But you know what happened, people? I went to Miracle Open Bible Church, which I go at this moment. And I feel it again. And I said, no, me I go, me I go. And I went to the altar. And trust me, today I can say, thank you, Jesus, when I accepted you. Because he have done so much things in my life. He take care of me. And I'm saying to those of you who have not accepted Christ, because we can say all kind of things, no, Miss Passley is dead. But you here, family members and friends, I am speaking to you. Make sure you get saved. Make sure you make God lead your life. Because hear what happened. When I look at my time now, and when I accept Christ and baptize, I believe I should accept Christ on an hour. I just accept Christ probably 10 years ago. But I believe I should accept him 20, 30 years ago. Because over here is so sweet. Over this side is so sweet. Because I always say, me love dance, and me always say, then me go miss dance, and me go miss this, me go miss that. But when I baptize and accept Christ and baptize, all of my friends them gone. Me not have no more friends because the place they used to go, me can't go there anymore. The girls have to give that a walk. And a lot of things you have to give a walk. But you know what happened? Over here in Jordan, over this side, everything is there, which is good. Understand? So let us praise God and continue to praise him. And those of you who accept him as yet, try accept him, because trust me, it's a nice way over here. Thank you, church. God bless you all.
Praise God. The scripture said, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Praise God. You know, we could have otherwise minded, but because of his love, we are here today. And I want to say to you that it's only because of the goodness of God. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 19 said, my grace is all you need, for my power is the greatest when you are weak. Psalm 73 verse 26 said, my flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Nehemiah 8 verse 10 said, do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is my strength. Glory. You know, I'm here this morning. I am feeling good and I'm not so feeling good. Because, you know, when you know somebody for 30 something years, we are not connected by flesh and blood. But I could almost say she was my mother. I don't know if any one of you here today have ever gone through hurt, disappointment, burden. You feel like you can't go on. I don't know if any one of you have that feeling in your life, but I have gone through it. And when I feel like I can't even sleep, and when I went to Westchester and I spoke with Miss Yvette, she said, you know, she said, you will be all right, man. She said, no worry. You know, she raised my daughter. So you can excuse me if I'm a little emotional. She put my daughter in a box in her living room. When I came from the country, you know, I'm all over the place when I'm talking. But she was the realest person. This family is the real, when I say real people, you know, I say, God, the good people are going. Where are we? Who we have left? Because, you know, this woman, I can't even, if I try to find words to express my feelings, I would be out of words. But I want to say, you know, I find a family who I'm not connected to by blood, but I feel like the Lord has joined me. Because when I left country and when I come to town, I didn't miss anybody. I have sisters. You know, you and your sister them quarrel, but for 30 something years, I know Marmar. You know, we normally now, I know Chinny, I know Sonia, and I know Kareen. But you know, me and Marmar was a little bit closer because we normally go to dance and party. And when I come to Miss Yvette, whenever I come there, if I don't look good, she has a Gandhi, anything at all, adorn me if you make me look good. So you know, it's a mother. She's a mother to me, was a mother to me, and she also a mother to my daughter. And I said, you know, when you know kind words, She said, don't worry yourself, man. God go and make a way. You know, I've been through a situation where I feel like I was going to lose my mind. And she, you know, she gave me hope and she talked to me and she said, don't worry yourself, man. You'll come out of it, man. I mean, I tell you, you know, but you see, when I looked at her photograph, I said, you know, we have everything, but the Lord has the timing in his hand. Because when I look, it said sunrise, February the 6th. And the Lord chose to take her out, February the 12th. The Bible said, our times are in the hand of the Lord. And I just want to say to you today, if you have not known the Lord as your personal Savior, ah, Jesus. Ah, God, make your calling an election. Sure, Bridget, it's rough, you know. But may I tell you, you know, you're when you have a strength. You're when she gone, I'm gonna have nobody. And may I say, Jesus, I'm feel, me feel like me I have somebody. Because may I tell you, me all of my relatives, them, their country, I'm left come a town 30 years. And me never ever feel like me have nobody. And sometimes when me no call her for a while, she said, Gandhi, a long time me no hear from you, you know. But, you know, me a check up on you. Oh, you do? You all right? And me a say, yeah, man, me good man, me a come check you. She said, don't worry yourself, man. Everything will be all right. So me a tell her, brethren, me really lose somebody when me love. Me a tell you, but, you know, we love her. But Jesus love her more. God bless you. God bless you. Glory.
Thank you so very much for those remembrances, reflecting on the life of a good woman. Amen? Amen. We have the offering that will be received at this time, and our hymn that we'll be singing at this time is, Oh Lord my God, when I in awe, some wonder, considering all, the worlds thine hands have made. The ushers are at the back, so they'll be coming up right up to you. So just be seated, be prepared as we sing and worship in our giving. Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder, considering all the worlds thine hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. I wonder and hear the birds sing sweetly in the tree. When I look down from lofty mountains grandeur and see the brook and feels the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior.
God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God, his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burdens gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Sing with me. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. Sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Somebody say, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. May I invite Minister Jackson to say thanks in prayer.
Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor and we exalt you, mighty God. And we thank you, Lord, for the blessing, almighty God, as your people have stretched forth their hands, mighty God, to return thanks in a monetary way to your kingdom. We thank you, Lord, that what they have given, Lord, will go to the establishment of the work of the kingdom here, for souls to be won for the kingdom. And we pray, Lord, that whatever measure they have put in, Lord, it will be good measure pressed down and shaken together and running over. Shall men continue to give in their bosoms, because you are no man's debtor. We thank you for all who were able to give. And for those who did not and held back for whatever reason, Lord, we pray that you'll continue to provide the resources for them, that they'll be able to bless the kingdom of God. To you be glory, honor, dominion, and power. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 To give our eulogy, we'll have Miss Carleen Allen, daughter, and immediately after the eulogy being presented, we'll be having the word of God spoken by Minister Robert Bartley. God bless you.
morning, everyone. My name is Carleen Allen, aka Kareen, the eldest of Miss Hyacinth May Passley. I'll be sharing her life in segments. Say not in grief, she is no more, but live in thankfulness that she was. Eskimo legend. Introduction to her life. I stand before you with mixed feelings as I begin to recount the life of an extraordinary person, my mother, Hyacinth Passley. As the eldest of six children, I have shared many memorable moments. I have heard the kind words and experienced the good gestures. As we gather today in memory of her, or whilst we mourn her passing, let us not dwell in a life lost, but for a life that was. Family, friend, and well-wishers, as we search for the right words to express our sorrows, let us find comfort in having the privilege in knowing the person she was. Her childhood years. Hyacinth May Passley, affectionately called Yvette, Miss Will, started her journey on this earth on February 6, 1946, to parents Ina Walker and Mr. Brian Passley at the Jubilee Hospital, Victoria Jubilee Hospital in Kingston. She was the eldest of seven children, and even at a tender age, she thought it fit to take care of her younger siblings. She attended the Russell Primary and later went on to learn craft and trade. And through this gift, she was invited by the American Embassy to study craft in the United States. Adult years. My mother spent most of her youthful years between West Street, Christopher Road, and Trenchtown in Kingston, where she raised four girls and one boy. Carleen, Sophia, Michelle, Vanessa, and Charles. After becoming pregnant with Cadian in the early 1980s, she applied for a home in the new upcoming scheme of Portmore and was successful. She moved to Westchester, where she lived the remainder of her adult year. Her husband and dear partner lived and raised us despite many obstacles. It was never an easy journey, but my mother had a way to make the complex task seem easy. To make ends meet, my mom would do just about anything. I remember her selling sock sock, formerly sock sock, no bag juice, cookies. Back in the days, we would call it mash mash. At U Sherlock All Age School, that is in Trenchtown, she would sew and make crochet tams. When my mother got her job at Jamaica Frozen Foods, that was in Portia Road, no Marcus Garvey Drive, she was working the night shift. She would pack our lunch individually, color code. Sonia will get the yellow, Michelle alias Marmar will get the red, and mine would be pink. My mother assigned us each our housework, and if any reason we had completed it too fast, she would have us do it all over again. She would say, take time and do things and do it good. My mother loved discipline. She was a family woman, and this was the foundation of her actions. Memorable moments. Our mother was the lover of life and the life of every party. Yvette would show up, and as she would say, dress to puss foot. She was quite fashionable, and while most of us would shy away from the camera, she was always ready to take a picture. I remembered when she was in the hospital, and myself and my sister Cadian would go there in the evenings. One particular day, we visited her and was about to leave, and she said, Cadie, how you are leaving and taking a picture of me? That was our mother. We had to take a picture each time for memories. This was important to her. My mother loved to dance, and dance she did. She was the lover of the arts and anything theatrical. My mother knows the latest steps, the latest move, the latest song. I remember one day that I visited her, and she was dancing a dance in a particular way, and I asked her,
what is that dance? She said, you don't know that dance there? I said, no. It named Gully Creeper. I said, oh. And she said, let me show you. And she did dance. The first four girls were members of the Tivoli Gardens dance troupe, an All Saints, All Age school. And she would show up at every rehearsal and performances. She will correct our movements. She will let us focus. And she will say, don't watch any face, just dance. The only time I recall my mother not showing up at one of our concerts was when we traveled overseas to Canada. And it was all because she didn't have a visa. But best believe, if my mother had her visa, she would have even booked her ticket long before us. She was one of those parents who believed in supporting her children, and not to mention the grandchildren. She took pride in talking about them, the sports day, the fairs, the pantomime, trips, you name it, she was there. Let's not get into funerals. My mother was at everybody's funeral who passed. I am sure if you were to view those family albums, there would be a picture of my mother somewhere in the background. It was just so funny to us as children. Kadian reminded me that at times she would come home and say, boy, the person get a good turnout. It was a good funeral. And then Kadian would say, mommy, there is no good funeral. And she would respond by saying, yes, man, you have good funeral. And judging by her standards, I believe this to be one of those good funerals. So I thank you all. Our mother was about giving no matter how small. Talk about Mother Teresa. And you are talking about my mother. My mother would give her umbrella on a rainy day and stand in the rain. Believe when I say she was just a beautiful soul. The stories are endless and time will not permit. Many of us are here today simply because she has touched your lives in a meaningful way. And you had to come and pay your last respect to this angel on earth. There are days when we as children were granted favors, and it turns out it was because of the good she did for others decades ago. We came from a very humbling beginning, and she has instilled this principle of giving within us. As a child, I witnessed my mother taking in children in her house, giving them a home until they could get on their feet. Adults too. The house was small, but she made it work somehow. Our mother was an advisor. I'm glad the invention of telephones. My mother played many roles, and one that stood out for us, and she played real well, was always having that shoulder to lean on and that listening ear. Everyone who has ever been in contact with my mother knows the wonderful counselor she was. Our days will certainly not be the same without the absence of these calls and regular check-ins. A mother knows when her child is in danger. She'll always call at the nick of time. Our mother was a lover of God and a peacemaker. You have to know to read the Bible. A fly my mother would never hurt. Trust God was her favorite utterance. Our mother was humble and wanted everyone just to get along. She was always the one trying to source the peace in every conflict. Our mother was a mother to all. It was always funny how persons would get thrown off when the children my mother raised would talk to other persons and mummy about mummy. Mummy and mommy, get it? Mummy and mommy. We had to be there to interpret the conversation when they use the term mummy and mommy in one sentence. For instance, when they say mummy, never tell mommy, it would mean our mother, Hyacinth, didn't tell their mother. Or if they ask mommy, when mummy, that is, it would suggest my mother, where's her boat? To be clear, let me read something that was sent by one such child. Dear mummy, remember mummy, expressing the death of your significance in my life is a challenge due to its profound impact.
yet I will endeavor to encapsulate the minute and ways you have touched my heart and influenced my journey. Your soul was so gentle, your heart was so wise and filled with love. Your spirit was so sweet. Getting those videos calls from Katie really had me on edge and worried. I prayed that you would pull through and get better and really notice significance of your illness, but this wasn't the outcome any of us was hoping for. That call at 8 a.m. from Debbie still plays over and over in my head to this day. Bad news, mummy passed. I hung up and immediately broke down into tears. It's been painful. So much good memories, mummy. Even a big family, you always welcome me with open arms. Always made sure everyone was good. You are a true definition of strong black woman. Just the way you balance it all. I was a kid, I didn't understand much, but now as an adult with kids and looking back at how you kept everyone and everything together is just unmatched. The best chef always made sure everyone eats the best two peas you will ever eat. Mummy, you always very humble and just all around great person. Give the best advice and she's always positive and smiling, and I'm grateful to have you as part of my journey. This is a painful word, but I know you would want us all to just keep our heads up and just keep making you proud. Writing this, one of the hardest things I have ever had to do. Hurts even more knowing that I am not able to be there, but I know you are at a peace with your God. Because mummy, I love you and your memories will forever live on. Last days. On Monday, February 12, 2024, her journey came to an end. After ailing for some time and a gradual decline in health, my dear mom passed away at the University Hospital of the West Indies from natural causes. A flame that once burned with such passion for family and life quietly went out. Hyacinth is survived by her husband, Alvin, 6 children, 8 grandchildren, 1 great-grand, 3 sisters, 2 brothers, and a mother. Yes, her mom is 99. For those of us who knew her, those of us who loved her, those of us who admired her, we will always miss that girl and that woman she turned out to be. Conclusion. To her children and those she adopted, Christopher, Anna, Plummy, Hopi, and the list goes on. We will miss the devoted and loving mother she was, the provider, the protector, the nurturer, the peacemaker, the advisor. Take comfort in knowing that her love for you was unconditional and that through she died. Though she died, her love never did. She was a mother first. This is the life of my mom. Thank you all for supporting us.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Seems like this was really a good mother, a good woman, a good community person. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here we are at this time. I must extend also my condolences to the family of the late Hyacinth May Passley, Yvette. I'm about to share a short word this morning. What I'm about to say will have no bearing on Yvette this morning. We are going to speak a little about ourselves. Amen. I want to read quickly 2 Corinthians chapter 5. I'm going to read about 5 verses. And it reads thus, "For we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, an house not made with hand, eternal in the heaven. For in this house we groan, earnestly desiring to be clothed up with our house which is from heaven. If so be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. For we who are in this tabernacle do groan, being burdened, not for what we would be unclothed, but clothed upon that mortality might be swallowed up of life. Now he who has wrought us for the selfsame thing is God, who also has given unto us the earnest of his spirit. Let us pray. Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus Christ, we want to thank you, God, for leading us safely thus far, God, throughout this service. God, we come to the time, Lord God, that your word must be delivered. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that the spoken word will be anointed. God Almighty, the heart of your people will be encouraged. The heart of your people, God, will be refreshed in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Lord God, we commit your words into your hand. Use me, Lord, for your glory. And let your name be exalted and be glorified. I want to use a theme this afternoon. When I heard that I was going to speak at this service, I search and I contemplate, what am I going to say to these people this morning? Many things came across my mind. But you know, I made a visit to the Apostle Paul, and I found him here in 2 Corinthians chapter 5. And we had a conversation. And I came up with a theme: death is not the final story. Death is not the final story. From the day you and I were born, we begin to write our life story. Amen? Wherever we work, the community that we live, wherever we go to church, to the dance, wherever we go, we are writing our life story. We have heard much about the life story of May this morning, of Yvette, rather. But let me get into the sermon. Of all the fear that plague the heart of man, none is greater than the fear of death. Am I speaking the truth? No man want to die. The man who carried the M16 and the gun, he don't want to die, even though he want to murder everybody, but he fears death. It is the greatest fear that sum up all other fear. We are afraid to die. We are afraid of what will happen when we die. Hallelujah. Life is short and uncertain. We are gathered here at this present time, but we don't know who is next. Hallelujah. Whether you're young or you're old, we don't know who is next. Life is short and uncertain. Hallelujah. What is your life? You're just a myth that appear for a little while, then you vanish. We are here today, but tomorrow we are gone. Hallelujah. Moses said to the Lord in Psalm 90, verse 5 and 6, you sweep men away in the sleep of death. They are like the new grass of the morning. Though in the morning it spring up and look fresh, but in the evening it is dry and withered. What is man? Men are proud and boastful. Some men believe that they are better than you. man is always on the lookout to be better than their peer. Man have accumulated riches, built great houses, and have traveled across the world. But man is afraid of debt. Your money does not guarantee your life tomorrow. Hallelujah. Oh God, it is estimated that 4.7 million persons die each month across the world. 4.7 million men are dying like flies all over the world. But does death win in the end? On this side of the grave, it's hard to tell. Hallelujah. I have to run through this. Death is not the end of the story. For those who know the Lord, the Bible tells us what lies ahead. For those who know Jesus, as we come to Corinthians 5, we discover the wonderful thing that is prepared for us. I say to us today, oh God, weeping may endure for the night, but joy comes in the morning. That is not the end of the story. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We know that if this earthly tent, we are living in a tent, because man is a tripart being. We have body, we have soul, and we have spirit. This is where we live, in this lump of clay. Amen? But the apostle said, oh God, if this tent were destroyed, we have a building of God, eternal in the heaven. This house is not built by human hand. The most important part of this verse come in the first three words. Now we know. Hallelujah. Death itself confronts us with many mysteries. No one who reads these words can say with certainty how much longer we will live. But as what happened after we die, many of us do not know. Amen? So as we live in this tent, oh God, I encourage man to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. For the Bible said, what is man that thou art mindful of him? Or the son of man that thou visitest him? Because you have made him a little lower than the angel, and you have crowned him with glory and honor. God loves and cares for man. God loves man so much that whatever situation you're in, God is always there if you call on him. Mando Rabahai. As we age, we pay more attention to the things like diet and exercise. Fitness is in. We have got Weight Watchers. We keep our weight. We go on diet because we don't want to have diabetes. Amen? So there are certain things that we eat no more. And when you're old like me, you walk your dog and you exercise your body to keep in shape. Amen? Because we want to stay healthy. But can I say to you, every day our body breaks down. Hallelujah. I'm not like when I was 20 years old. I'm over 60 odd years old, and I can't do the things that I used to do when I'm 20. Hallelujah. Oh God, in spite of everything, one day we will trade away this old tent. So death is a transaction where we trade away this old tent that we live in to gain a body that that comes from God. Hallelujah. Oh God, think about the difference between a tent and a building. A tent, are temporary, flimsy. Tent can be torn, oh God, and tent can be replaced. But a building is strong. A building has a foundation that cannot be moved. Someday, we will give up this tent and replace it with a building made by God Himself. Oh God, that's one fact that tells us something important about death. Death is not the end. Death is not reincarnation. Death is not evaporation. And death is not annihilation. One day, we will trade, oh God, our broken down bodies for a new body. Hallelujah. Look what Paul said about this new body. It is from God. Hallelujah. It is not made with human hand. It is eternal and it is in the heaven. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. One day there is gonna be a resurrection of the body. Hey, God. Hallelujah. When you go to a cemetery, you don't know the Christian body from those that are not Christians. All you see in a cemetery is dead bodies. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, God Almighty. All you can see in cemetery is grave. But one day, there is gonna be a shaking. Oh, hallelujah. Oh God, for the Bible declare that this robe of flesh shall drop and rise to cease the everlasting price. There is a price that is awaiting us after death. Hallelujah. Oh God Almighty, Paul gave some answer. When Paul said we long to be clothed, he used an unusual Greek verb. That means something like to be clothed upon. It has the idea of putting on an overcoat, which is literally a coat put over or upon the body. Paul looked forward to the day when Christ returned and think to himself, I can't wait. My God. Hallelujah. Paul said, I can't wait for that day when I will change out of this mortal body. For this mortal shall put on immortality, and this corruption shall put on incorruption, and the same shall be brought to pass. Death is swallowed up in victory. Jesus said, oh death, where is thy sting? Oh grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who has given us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. One day, hallelujah, we are gonna change this old tent. Mando Rabahai. This tent, oh God, have done damage. We will be free from cancer. No more cancer when we change this tent. We will be free from the abuse. We will be free from hatred. Oh God, we'll be free from hurricane and man-made disaster. We will be free from crime. We'll be free from sadness. We'll be free from sickness. We will be free from death. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah. So even though man fear death, hallelujah, but oh God, there is gonna be a resurrection. But there's a difference in the resurrection. I'm coming down. Hallelujah. God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to pay the price for your sin. Hallelujah. And he's calling man to come to him. Man has rejected God. Man's behave as if they're bigger than God. Hallelujah. Oh God, there are a lot of critics when it comes to churches. They criticize pastors and ministers and members, but you can go criticizing. One day, you're going to have to stand before the judgment seat of God. And just like pastors have to give account, you're going to have to give account to God for the deeds done in your body. Hallelujah. There's going to be a resurrection of the righteous. My God, I can't. There's going to be a resurrection of the righteous. Oh God, for the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall rise. There is going to be a resurrection. And no grave, if you want to put me 12 feet down, that will not stop me. If you want to burn this body, that will not stop me. I will be here to answer the call of the resurrection. But after that resurrection, those who know not the Lord, hallelujah, will be banished to everlasting punishment. A man say, God wicked. God is a just God. God make man, and God has given every man a choice. Choose ye this day whom you will serve. If God be God, serve him. And if Baal be your God, then serve him. But choose this day whom you will serve. Hallelujah. I have a lot to say, but I am going to stop here. Hallelujah. The Christian have a guarantee. You know, Jesus, you know, make a loan payment for you and I. Oh, hallelujah. My God. You know something? You make a deposit. That means when you make a deposit, Jesus don't owe nobody anything. And when he make a deposit, he's gonna certainly pay it all. I challenge those of us this morning or this afternoon who are here. I hear Mr. Oscar said that the greatest thing that has ever happened to him in life is when he came to know Jesus Christ. God, hallelujah. This is a special day, a very special moment for you. Will you make, oh God, your election sure? Before we go, I want to pray with somebody this morning or this afternoon quickly. If you have not yet known the Lord, can you stand? Can you stand if you do not know the Lord as your Savior? Come on, we can't fool God, you know. Hallelujah. We can't fool God. We can't fool him. Hallelujah. If you are standing, can you just come to the altar quickly? We want to get this thing over quickly. Thank you, Jesus. Clap her as she comes. The Bible said, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. If you sow to the flesh, you shall have the flesh reap corruption. And if you sow to the spirit, you shall have the spirit reap life everlasting. Is there another person this morning? Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh God, we are going to give everybody a chance. Hallelujah. Oh God Almighty. Death is not the final story. Oh, hallelujah. For those who die in the Lord, it is not the final story. Oh, God, but if you need your story to continue, I'm going to ask you to come. All right? There is three persons who are standing. Thank you for coming. Hallelujah. I know as you are standing
here. I can't force you in making any decision, right? Because man have a choice. Amen? Man have a choice. If I'm giving you something that is valuable, I'm sure that if I'm giving out $1 million to each person, the congregation maybe would be empty right now. But I'm giving you something or somebody that is more valuable than silver or gold or precious ointment. I'm giving you Jesus. I'm giving you Jesus this morning. Hallelujah. Do you believe that Jesus is Lord? Do you believe that he died for your sin? Do you believe that he's coming back? Hallelujah. And in his coming back, you want to go with him. But at this moment, search your heart. Are you ready to go with him? He make a statement that we must repent and be converted, that our sins may be blotted out when times of refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. There is a time of refreshing this morning. Hallelujah. I want you to raise your hand and say after me. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for this glorious opportunity that I can be called to this altar to confess you as my Lord and Savior. Lord, I believe that Jesus died and paid for my sin. I believe that through his word, which declare that if I believe in my heart and confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus, then I will be saved. Lord, I believe that Jesus is Lord. I confess with my mouth that he is the Savior of the world. Lord, forgive me of all my sins and cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Thank you, God, for washing me. Thank you, God, for saving me. In Jesus' name. Do you believe that prayer? If you believe, raise your hands. Don't be ashamed to raise those hands. Hallelujah. Do you believe that you have confessed and you believe that you are saved this morning? Come on. I want real people. Do you believe? She believed. Do you believe? Do you believe? Put your hands together for them. It doesn't happen in a moment. It is a process. Hallelujah. Bishop, can you just pray for them quickly as they go on there? Hallelujah.
And so, Father, we thank you for these who have walked from where they were seated to this place to make a confession of their faith in preparation for their future. I pray that the anointing of God will rest upon them even now, and that every sin of the past will be blotted out and forgiven. We declare in the name of Jesus that your Holy Spirit will fill them up with resurrection power, waiting for the day when you shall come, and they will quickly be gathered to meet you when the trumpet is sounded. We thank you for hearing our prayers on their behalf. Break every curse from 10 generations on both sides of their families, so that they will inherit the blessings of Abraham through Jesus Christ. We thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name, let the church say, amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I'm going to be asking the congregation to stand and all the members of the family to remain seated. Congregation, those who are supporting the family, all the family members, just remain seated where you are. I want us to know, want you to know that we are praying for you. We're praying for you because We know that the enemy is deceptive, and he will do every and anything to prevent you from escaping the punishment that is coming at the end of the world. We want you to be able to escape. As the preacher said earlier, we cannot, Miss Yvette cannot hear us. She is gone. So we preach to those who are alive and still have another opportunity to allow Jesus to become Lord of your lives. For you, we are praying. And we pray, as I learned, that this gentleman is Miss May's husband. And we want to pray his strength, that whatever is happening, even in his body. And as the preacher talks about this tent, we will have to give it up in the future. But more than anything else, one has to be a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ, so that this mortal will put on immortality, and so that there can be the great resurrection when that time comes. I'm going to pray for the family. So Father, as the family remains seated, we thank you for the members of this family. There are so many that in their hearts and mind might not have yet made a public confession of their faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray in the name of Jesus, as I listen to the eulogy, as I listen to the various speakers, I pray that members of the family today will begin to recognize that there has to come a point when they make a turnover of their lives over to Jesus Christ. They have to come to that place. While we are born in this world, we must come to that place where we say to the Lord Jesus, I believe that you died for my sins. And as a result of dying for my sins, I accept you as my Lord and Savior, and continue to believe, awaiting the day when the Lord Jesus will come back for those who believe in him. For if any man have this hope in him, must purify himself, even as he is pure. And so we pray for the family that before they leave this place this morning or today, they will have said yes to the Lord Jesus and allow Jesus to become Lord of their lives and become a part of the church, become a part of the institution that God, through Jesus Christ, paid the penalty of death for each man, so that we can be in the church. The church, a symbol of the ark that saved Noah and his household from the deluge, the flood that came to destroy the entire world in his day. That it is, the world is going to be destroyed again, but only those who are safe in Jesus Christ will escape the judgment that is yet to come. And the Lord promised that he will not destroy this earth with water again, but the next time it will be fire. So I pray that God, this family will escape that which is to come, prepare for the future, and allow the Lord Jesus Christ to become Lord of their lives. More than all, I pray for their comfort this morning, this afternoon, that they will find comfort in knowing that if they believe in Jesus Christ, there is hope. if Miss Yvette had trusted her life into the hands of Jesus Christ, there is hope for them to see her again in Jesus Christ. And so we ask, Lord, comfort this family. Comfort this family, that this family will know that they don't have to cry as those who have no hope. We must cry because we are humans and we feel the pain of loss. But we don't have to cry as those who have no hope. And so I pray, Father, that as you strengthen this family, touch those who are sick. Touch those who are experiencing grief and pain. And I pray that, Lord, today there will be burdens, as the song says, burdens are lifted at Calvary. That in Jesus Christ there is hope. Say hope. Hope is in Jesus Christ. Strengthen this family, Lord, that in the days ahead when they will call but there will be no answer on the cell phone of Yvette, I pray that they will be comforted to know, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. Father, I pray that, Lord, your name will be glorified in this family, that each one will allow you to become their Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the church say, amen. Thank you so very much. You may be seated for a little while as we wrap everything up. Let me give you a few information. Thank God we will be having police escort, and they will assist us in getting to Medeiros in good timing. I know the route that we're going to be taking. Please follow the police escort so that we can get to Medeiros in good timing. So I'm sure he's going to tell us. Now, we are going to be going down Grange Lane, and then go into Spanish Town Bypass so that we can, that is the safe and best lane or a route we will take. The recessional hymn is Sing the Wondrous Love of Jesus. Sing His mercies and His grace. When we get to the second stanza, I'm going to be asking the pallbearers to be coming along with the young men at the back who will direct, the directors of the funeral will come and lead us out. The Minister Bartley and I will go first, then the casket will follow after, then the family members, and then the well-wishers will come after as we go out. Immediately after we are out, there is refreshment at that tuck shop, so you can go and refresh yourselves. But in 10 or so minutes after, we want to be leaving this location to go to Medeiros before it rains. And so, please, whatever you do, let us do it quickly, so that we can be out of here in good timing. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus. Sing His mercies and His grace. In the mansion bright and blessed, He'll prepare for us a place. When we all we'll see Jesus.
spread the sky. Thank you. time shall be no more. 2, 3. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saves of earth shall gather to their home on the shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share. Labor for the master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
May the name of the Lord be praised. In his divine providence, our God has chosen to call to eternity, to eternal rest, the soul of our dear deceased sister. Therefore, we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, awaiting the resurrection in the last day, the life of the world to come, though through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, at whose glorious appearing the earth, the sea, shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his glorious body. Let us share in a prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. There are a number of songs that we are going to be singing at this time as the men do their last. We'll sing the same song again and then we do some choruses. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the people gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. On that bright and proud this morning when the dead in Christ shall rise and the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen one shall gather to their home beyond the skies and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Maybe by the river someday.
Maybe by the river, not far away. Oh, when my Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the sky. Maybe by the river someday. Maybe by the river. By the river, not far away. Oh, when my Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the skies. Meet me by the river someday. Oh, meet me by the river someday. Oh, meet me by the river. Meet me by the river someday. One more time. Meet me by the river someday. Meet me by the river, not far away. Oh, when my Lord shall call me home, happy, happy home beyond the sky. Meet me by the river someday. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Now, during the service, there was an item that was, the soloist wasn't here yet, but he's here now and he wants to sing that song. Could you come on my right, Peter Williams, family friend, and he will do his rendition at this time.
Why should I feel this courage? And why should the shadow come? And why should my heart feel lonely and long forever and long? When Jesus is my portion, his eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches me.
Second verse.
Why? Again. Why, Lord, why? Why should I be? Why should my heart feel lonely
and longing for heaven and home when Jesus is my bosom and constant man is he. His eye is on the sparrow and I know, he watches me. I said whenever I am tempted, whenever clouds arise, when song gives place to sign, and when hope within me die, Lord, I drew close, so close to him. Oh, from sin, yeah, my Jesus set me free. That's why, Lord, I can see, yeah, I'm seeing because I'm happy, yes, I see because really I'm free.
Let us join him, I say, because out of
glory to the Most High.
One more time, I sing because I'm free. I sing because I'm free. His eye is on the sparrow, and I know he watches.
Hallelujah.
Come on, say hallelujah.
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 Jesus. Hallelujah.
Sleep on, beloved. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you well, but Jesus loves you best. Good night. One more time. Sleep on, beloved. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you well, but Jesus loves you best. Good night. All right, let me, on behalf of the family, thank all the well-wishers who have come along to bear their arms up in this most difficult time of bereavement. And they acknowledge that the program says the family of the late Hyacinth May Passley would like to express sincere thanks and gratitude to each of you who have prayed, visited, called, sent flowers or other expression of love and kindness to us during our time of bereavement. We will cherish and remember the love you shared with us as a family. May God continue to bless every one of you.
I want to also say that if you do not have a church home, we invite you to share with us at the church that the funeral was held. We start on Sundays at 8:30. You are welcome to join us. God bless you. We also offer counseling services on Tuesdays, Wednesdays, and on Fridays. God bless you. May the grace, the mercy of God, could we raise our hands? And now unto him that is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, and above all that we are able to ask, to think, or even imagine, according to the power that is at work within us. God bless you. Safe travel home, and the grace of the Lord be with you all.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak.
This has been an XMalcom Media production. For more information and bookings, call us at 1-876-369-6604 or check us out on YouTube at XMalcom Media or Instagram and Facebook at XMalcom Media.